service today. There's a church meeting having to do with the bell tower, and invite everyone to stay for that. And if I remember, Dave, we were going to lock the doors and have people get their purses and wallets, and then we'll start. But the meeting is still coming after our church service. I invite you to hang around for that, please. In your insert, looking forward to the youth volleyball game for tonight is at St. James, but it starts at 6, not 6:30. And there will be a doubleheader, so lots of volleyball going on this evening. Come and cheer on our team. As you look through then the next part of this, following youth volleyball supplies still needed, there is, as you can see, a lot that has come in, of which I am terribly excited for and about, and everything is coming together. We have about 20 kids that are currently signed up. We always have room for more, and we always have room for another pair of hands to help us on either that Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday. I want to call out a few of our church members for birthdays and anniversaries. Birthdays on July 18th, Sue Johnson. And then Haley Henschel and Jane Bandowski. Randall Krause. Emily Urbit. Owen Bramstead. Ronald Hansman. Jan Marcheski. Madison Flanagan. Wish them a happy birthday the next time you see them, or send them a birthday card. And then anniversaries, Corey and Amy Clement, Richard and Sarah Lucy, Tim and Wendy Schuler, and Hank and Barb Ryan. Congratulations to them. On the inside of that insert, as long as we are there, you open it up and you'll see the scripture verse on one side and the GPS on the other side. The road place study is some commentary to go along with our series in the Apostles' Creed, as well as today's message, with some additional text to read, scriptural text. And I'm also encouraging you to read one of the other creeds, like the Nicene Creed. It's easily found. It might even be in our hymnal. If you have access to Google, you can always Google it. Google has everything. It's pretty awesome. On the back then is notes for today or throughout this week as you are reading the extra scripture and going through the commentary that I've written and the prayer at the end. You might find notes or thoughts coming to mind. You want to write them down. Perhaps that's questions for me for the next week, or you want to send me something in email, or call me, or invite me out to breakfast. I will come. We also have our welcome card. I encourage you to fill that out and drop it in the offering plate for our offering. On the back, there is a place for prayer requests and praises. We'll have that same opportunity in our time of worship, but sometimes it's just a little bit easier on us if we write it down rather than to speak it out loud. You have an insert for one of the hymns that we will be singing. Come, your blessings set that aside for now. And I believe that's it for announcements. I am delighted that Sammy Peroni is here this morning and will be our liturgist, our reader, and with that, I'm going to invite her up as she leads us in the call to worship.
Please stand as you wish and join me in our responsive call to worship. Living, he loved me.
And I gave him his life, his grace, and I
justified me freely forever.
And all are justified freely by the grace through redemption that came in Christ Jesus.
One day he is returning. Oh, glorious day. Please join me together in saying our opening prayer. Heavenly Father,
jump right into our prayer of confession, but I want to take a moment. We don't have Young at Heart this morning, but I see that Peter is here with us. And I'm wondering, Peter, would you come up and help me with something? Come on up. Thank you for this day. Thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you for the Holy Spirit. We thank you for this church family. And ask that you bless all of the children, those who are here, and those who are here in spirit. We lift this prayer to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Try to save ourselves. We want to wash our hands from all guilt and declare our innocence when someone accuses us of unfaithfulness. We cry out, my God, why have you forsaken me? When it is ourselves who have forsaken God. We cannot live with the burden of our sin. Grant us your forgiveness in Christ's name. Let's pray together the words of assurance. Nothing can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. Christ has taken the burden and the guilt of our sins to the cross, and through his death and resurrection, granted us access.
rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, one holy universal Christian church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Friends, if you pull out that insert, count your blessings, we'll sing that next. Number 281 from the Pilgrim People, count your blessings. There is a front and back.